One of the practice activities that we were not able to get to in class is practicing using VLOOKUP on the payroll database for Generesto. So what we're going to do is bring in data from other Excel files, so specifically the work expertise table and other Generesto employee information, which can be found in this week's folder, and we're going to bring it into the payroll database. So we're going to practice using VLOOKUP, and specifically we're going to say what occupations have work expertise classification and how many are there in each. Now the work expertise is broken down into, the next slide here, memory knowledge, new knowledge, and current knowledge. So the memory knowledge is defined as remembering the old materials, techniques for building infrastructure from projects that were created a long time ago. New knowledge is defined as basically cutting edge engineering techniques that have been created within universities or innovative companies. And current knowledge are basically those engineering principles that are commonly known and well understood and used for today's buildings and structures. Okay, so with this, let's go to payroll database. So let me just quickly do a consolidated list of all the divisions here. So add a new tab, and this is great review, because we've been doing this so often, so I'll copy the first row. Put it here, and now I'm going to do my VStack. But first, I'll do filter VStack, and I'm going to take in all the divisions. Here we go, and there we are. Now I'm going to change the range because I know that we have more than 673 rows. Because right now I'm currently in the HQ. Division tab here, and you can see the little green line under the names. So that means that's the one that's active. So I'm just going to change this to something quite large where I know that it'll far exceed the number of employees. There we are, comma. So VStack that, comma. Now I've got to filter it. So I'm grabbing all the data here, and I'm going to change it so I only want to filter, so I only want to show employees where the employee ID is not blank. And I personally like using this less than or equal to quotation marks because I've seen certain situations where if I just apply the closed bracket, hit enter, it works. Other times it doesn't. I can't tell you why it does and why it doesn't work sometimes and why it does, but if this doesn't work, just remember, if you do this, does it not equal to, do quotation marks, this should make it work. All right, so here we go. We've done this. Let me just open up all the column headings so it's easy to see. Great. So what are we asking for? So let's bring in, we got work expertise table and other Generesto employee information. So I already have open the work expertise table. So we have employee IDs and the category work expertise. We want to bring this into here. So we'll call this work expertise. So we'll start off with equals VLOOKUP. What are we looking up here? We're looking up the employee ID, comma, and I'll go to my Excel file. And I just clicked onto it. That's it. I went over to the new file that I'm looking for, trying to bring stuff into, and I clicked on work expertise, and I'm going to click in the first, well, in column A with the first employee ID, hold control, shift, hold it down, tap the right arrow once, and down. Now you'll notice that it puts some extra details in here. First of all, got this works expertise table, it's the name of the file, and then right beside it we have the tab name. You don't have to type this in yourself. Excel automatically puts it in as you select cells in a new or in another Excel file. Okay, so let's type in comma. How many columns over? Well, in this case, we only have two columns, comma two, comma false. So I want to get an exact match. All right, now hit enter. Well, we're getting an error message. Well, is this error message appropriate? Well, so we've been conditioned to say if there's an error message, we must have made a mistake with our formula. But in this case, we haven't. Let me explain why. Look at the employee ID that we're trying to look up here. It's 100,000. We're pulling it from this work expertise table. I'll go back to my work expertise table, go to the very top. So this is ordered in ascending order. Look at the first employee. The first employee isn't 100,000. It's 100,002. So that means that employee for 100,000 doesn't exist in this table. Look, I'll show you. Control F, 100,000. We can't find it. So that employee does not have a work expertise designation. That's why we're getting this error message. So let's copy it down. We're getting a lot of error messages here. It's not, can't find it. Keep going. Okay. So as I'm scrolling down, now I'm starting to get a little bit worried. Did I really make a mistake? Like, really, we have all these people that don't have a worker designation? Let's keep on going. Keep on going. I'm scrolling a bit faster. Look at this, I'm already on row 650. Oh, here we go. The first person on row 675. They're a drafter. And they have work expertise of memory. Okay, remember, memory refers to the old wave and old practices. Okay. So I feel better. I've found one person here. And go down and find more and more people. All right, it'll make more sense. Look at this person here. They're a drafter. And they're in the division of civil. All the previous ones here are from headquarters. So clearly, people that are not associated with the engineering and technical side of the company. Okay, that's fine. All right. So let's bring in some of the other elements too, just for additional practice. What do we have in the other GenRestim data? We have parking pass, number, first aid certificate. Okay, well, I'm going to copy these two headings, bring it over into the payroll database. I'll paste them right here. And let's pull out that information as well too. Equals VLOOKUP. And what am I pulling up? Well, the employee ID, comma. I'm going to find it here, but now I'm going to select this entire range. Okay. Comma, two, comma, false. Reason why? It's because I'm pulling in the parking pass information right now. So that's in the second column. And we get another error message. That just means this employee does not have a parking pass. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this formula over. I'm still getting an error message. You may think, okay, that seems to make sense. However, look what the reference is now. It's looking up B2 because I copied the formula over to the right. Now it's looking up the second column information. That's not what I want. So I'm going to go in and change that from a B to an A. So now it's looking up the employee ID. This other element, the first aid certificate, how many columns over does that data point reside in the original data set? Well, this is column 1, that's 2, and that's 3. So I have to be aware, I have to change now the lookup to 3 columns over, not 2. So I'll change, there we go, there's the 2, delete that, and type in 3. All right. So now I'm going to select these both and copy them all the way down. And it looks like there we go. We got some people here within headquarters. We have the parking pass and the certificate number for the first aid. All right, so it seems to be working properly. So now, in order to do the second part here, I want to take a look at what occupations have a work expertise and how many are they. We have to do a pivot table. So I click anywhere in the data set, insert pivot table. Now we're doing it by occupation. Here we go. And I'm going to pull out the next things, and it doesn't appear to be here. Okay, let's take a look at this. Why is that the case? Huh. So I was expecting to pull in a columns O, P, and Q. Since it didn't do that, since we don't have the fields here, I'm going to go to Pivot Table Analyze, change data source. Okay, and I'm going to manually change this. I don't want N. I want to go to Q. I'll type in Q, hit OK, and now the fields are available. Okay, so work expertise, we'll put that into columns. And I'll do a count of employee ID. Don't forget, change it from sum to count. There we are. So we have current, memory, new, and not available. So we take a look at it. Let's clean this up a little bit more. We only want people with a work expertise designation. So to filter it, I'll click in the little down arrow beside column labels, deselect NA, hit OK. And here we have it. We have the employees that have a work designation for either current, memory, or new. And these are our technical individuals, drafters, engineers, technician engineering, and trades. Again, it makes sense because if we're taking a look at the work expertise based on these definitions, it's the people who work with each type of knowledge. Your accountants wouldn't be associated with any one of these. Your administrative assistants wouldn't be associated with one of these type of specialty knowledge or expertise. So when you think about it a little bit, it makes sense why they're not showing up. All right, so that's something that we also want to do. Whenever we're pulling information, does it make sense in terms of what we're seeing? Can we explain it logically? So let me put this back here. It does. So the accountants, analysts, building maintenance people, they're not working on projects, so they wouldn't be associated with a type of knowledge specific to engineering. So that's why the designation is not available. It couldn't be found. So it gives us additional confidence too that all these NAs that we were seeing, it makes a logical sense. Okay, so I encourage you to practice this on your own in order to build up your VLOOKUP skills. And when you see these error messages, does it make sense to you? And to double check them as you go through your work. And then subsequently doing a pivot table in order to be able to answer the questions that we're looking at here in terms of identifying those people that have a specific work expertise.